What do you think is better at finding a hidden bomb? This or one of these?
All right, it's Tuesday, January 19th, day before the inauguration. Ugh, my bike just fell over again.
One of the reactions animators was recently biking around Washington, D.C. instead of doing his job and spotted what we're pretty sure is some sort of bomb sniffer, a device that tests the air for molecules that could be coming from an explosive. It's like an electronic version of a bomb sniffing dog. He might not have even noticed it had we not been working on a video about this exact thing right before the pandemic. We'd heard rumors that some of the bridges around DC had these sniffers on them that would notify police if someone was trying to sneak a bomb into Washington. We had zero understanding of how these things might work, or if it was even possible to detect bombs from that far away, but we decided, what the heck, let's go look for some. You're filming this.
Hello.
Remember back when we could walk around without masks?
So I'm looking to see if I can see anything that's not just obviously a metal bridge. I'm hoping that that pipe doesn't need to carry anything important. I'm not seeing anything. Definitely nothing obvious. I mean, I see stuff hanging under the bridge. Yeah, I saw a couple that looked like bells. Right there, there's something hanging down. I don't know what it is, but it's something.
We realized that it's hard to find something when you have no idea what you're looking for. So we went to the experts.
So fun.
This is the US Naval Research Laboratory in Washington, DC, where chemists work with detection dogs as well as explosives trace detectors, also known as electronic sniffers. There we met chemists Dr. Lauryn DeGreef and Dr. Braden Giordano. But the day's VIP was Eddie, the very sweet detection dog. Dogs are known for being able to sniff out different scents, but how do they actually do that? Dogs have cells deep in their noses called olfactory sensory neurons. Each of those cells has multiple receptor proteins that stick out from the cell's surface. When a dog sniffs, it's taking a little sample of the hundreds or thousands of different volatile chemicals dispersed in the air, which could be coming from a fire hydrant, neighborhood trash, or a bomb. Some of those compounds bind to the receptor proteins, causing the receptor protein to change shape, triggering an electrochemical signal to the dog's brain, which interprets a smell. Humans have the same basic system, but there are a couple of things about a dog's nose and nasal cavity that make it ideal for detecting smells.
The canine olfactory system is set up a little bit differently than humans. For one, they can breathe and smell as separate processes, so those chambers in their nose and behind their nose are separated, so they can be breathing and sniffing and processing odor at the same time. When dogs sniff out, they sniff out very frequently. And if you've ever looked closely at a dog's nose, they have the little slits on the side of their nose.
Yeah.
So when they blow out, the air blows back. And when it blows back, it actually entrains or pulls air from in front of it towards the dog's nose. Mm-hmm. So they get a bigger sample, something that humans certainly don't do.
Right. Right, that's really cool.
Eddie can actually detect around 38 different explosives.
Now that he's already trained in the act of detection, so he already knows how to do detection work, you can train him on a new odor in a matter of hours.
I decided to put him to the test with some smokeless powder in a training aid delivery device, or TAD. Smokeless powder is a common ingredient in pipe bombs and a lot of other homemade explosives.
There. Okay. So this is...
It still has sand on it.
This is a little sand from the last training. I'm going to take this smokeless powder that's in this TAD and I'm gonna hide it and see if Eddie will be able to find it. Where should I go?
I buried it a few inches under the sand. I was excited to see how he'd do.
Let's see what happens. Got it. Hey.
Okay. Next, Dr. DeGreef showed me this mixed odor delivery device, or MOD, that she developed to train dogs to sniff out explosives. You can put up to 4 different chemicals into the MOD, and each has its own chamber. So the dog is able to smell the combination of chemicals in a bomb, but because they're kept separate, you're not actually making a bomb. Dr. DeGreef took us to try out the MOD and see Eddie in an indoor situation he'd be more likely to encounter in real life.
Come here. Oh, you're so cute.
We hid MODs around an empty office of cubicles. I put the MOD with smokeless powder in one of the trash cans, and Dr. DeGreef hid empty control MODs around the rest of the office. It did not take Eddie very long to find the smokeless powder. He's good at his job. But if an electronic sniffer can do the same thing in human hands, that's a pretty powerful tool. Electronic sniffers work similar to a dog's nose in that they are detecting volatile compounds.
This is sampling a vapor, just like the dog is. It's sniffing, and in this case, it has a pump.
Electronic sniffers can take samples from the air directly or use a swab. Either way, the compounds are drawn through a glass tube that's coated with molecules that interact with certain targets, say explosives like TNT or TATP. When they do interact, the molecules will fluoresce or light up. Light sensors in the sniffer detect that fluorescence and then tell you whether the target molecule is there. Now, with a quick training session, it was my turn to be put to the test. One of the researchers at the lab hid the sample for me to detect, and I was off.
Let's see how this goes. Start over here. 6, 5, 4.
It was not quick.
No threat detected. I'm gonna, okay.
Several minutes later.
Eddie won this round because, well, electronic sniffers like these are not designed to do what I did here, find buried explosives, or find them in a big open room. That's where dogs have a major advantage. They can quickly move around until they pick up on a scent. Electronic sniffers are designed for smaller spaces, like a bottle or a box, or to be used with swabs, like what TSA does when you're selected for extra screening. And they have some distinct advantages over Eddie. You can have a bunch of them, they don't take hours and hours of training like dogs do, and the technology is only getting better. Right now, a combo of dogs plus electronic sniffers is our best bet at detecting bombs. As for the electronic sniffers on bridges around DC, we're still looking. If you've heard this same rumor or know someone who has some intel, let us know.